May the clues that they discover and the memories they uncover to the road we each must find. Oh, may all who've come behind us find us faithful. May the fire of our devotion light their way. May the footprints that we leave lead them to believe, and the lives we live inspire them to obey. Oh, may all who've come behind us find us faithful.
Thank you, Brother Earl. May buntag ka na itong tanan. Salamat sa Ginoo, sa iyang grasya, o sa kusog kabasog ngayong gihatag ka na ito karun, nga we can come early this morning to be blessed of our lesson. Okay, so let us open our Bibles to the book of Hebrews chapter 12. Hebrews chapter 12, and we shall be reading together the verses from verse 14, 15, and 16. Okay? So before we do that, let us pray. Lord, Heavenly Father, we thank you so much for the privilege that we can come early this morning to be blessed of the lesson that you have inlaid before our hearts so that this can be shared to your people, not only here in this congregation, but as well as those who are tuned in online all over the globe. Thank you, Father, Lord, that we can be nourished spiritually with the things that we can derive from your word. Oh, bless our gathering this morning, and we give you all the praises, honor, and glory in Christ's most wonderful name. Amen. While you are there, we would like to extend warm greetings from Bible Baptist Church, 55 Katipunan, Cebu City, to all our brothers and sisters in Christ, and to those also who are tuned in this live streaming. Maing adlaw kanatong tanan. And also, we would like to extend our deep sympathies and prayer of comfort for the family of Brother Ben Iscasinas, for his wife, for the demise of his wife, Ma'am Elena Iscasinas. They are now joining with Ma'am Gisalba and the rest of those who have gone before us. And there is going to be a great reunion there up in heaven. Okay? Hebrews chapter 12, verses 14, 15, and 16. Okay? Shall we read together? Hebrews chapter 12, verses 14, 15, 16, and... Okay, ready? Go. Follow peace with all men, and holiness without which no man shall see the Lord. Looking diligently, lest any man fail of the grace of God, lest any root of bitterness springing up trouble you, and thereby many be defiled. Lest there be any fornicator or profane person, as Esau, who for one morsel of bread, meat, sold his birthright. Okay, thank you. Please be seated. Our memory verse is the text that we just read, Hebrews 12, but 14 and 15. So let us commit to memory these verses 14 and 15, Hebrews 12, 14 and 15. So once again, let us recite and really commit this to our memory. 14 and 15 of Hebrews chapter 12. Okay, ready, go. Hebrews 12, 14. Follow peace with all men and holiness, without which no man shall see the Lord. Looking diligently, lest any man should men fail of the grace of God, lest any root of bitterness springing up trouble you, and thereby may be defiled. Okay, our lesson this morning is entitled Remembering Grace. Remembering Grace, and this is the ninth lesson in the series Grace for the Pace. Grace for the Pace. So, ika-siyam na ning leksyon, and there are 13 lessons in this series, so we have still 4 to go, okay? So our theme is printed in the opening paragraph of the outline, which you have a copy. So let us recite together the theme of this lesson. Okay, together now, ready, go. Though a Christian cannot lose his salvation, the risk of failing the grace of God is always present. Forgetting the purpose and power of God's grace places us right in the path of this danger. As Christians, we need to specifically and intentionally remember what God has done for us. In this lesson, we will look at three specific areas of remembrance vital to the Christian life. And what are these? Forgiving, focusing, and fearing the Lord. Okay, so that is the theme of the lesson. The three areas that we ought to constantly remember is that of forgiving, focusing, and fearing the Lord. The goals of this lesson are as follows. Ready? With your ball pen, grasp the dangers of forgetting God's grace. It is very dangerous to forget the grace of God. The dangers, let us understand that. Number two, be prepared to work on forgiving those who have hurt us. Forgiving those who have hurt us. This is very challenging, not only to the unbelieving people, but to God's people as well, like you and me. Very challenging to be able to work on forgiving those who have hurt us. Number three, know the warning signs of bitterness. Know the warning signs of bitterness. Number four, focus on our future in heaven and on Jesus Christ. Number five and last, understand the true meaning of what? The true meaning of the fear of the Lord. The fear of the Lord is the beginning of wisdom. Without the fear of the Lord, it is difficult to really acquire heavenly wisdom. There are 3 points that we have inlined in this lesson. First, remember to forgive. Remember to forgive. Then remember to focus. Remember to focus. And remember to fear the Lord. Okay? So, notice with this observation, the Filipino people have set aside a day to honor heroes, to honor the bravery of those Filipino heroes who give up their lives in order to provide for the foundation of our country's independence. Okay? And literally, these people, these Filipino heroes, have laid down the foundation of freedom that we enjoy with their blood. This year's celebration will be on August 22, this year, the National Heroes Day. We will be celebrating for the purpose of what? We will be celebrating for the purpose of remembering what these Filipinos had done for our countries. The likes of Dr. Jose Rizal, Andres Bonifacio, Apolinario Mabini, Emilio Aguinaldo, Juan Luna, Gregorio Del Pilar, Gabriela Silang, the wife of Jigo Silang, Melchora Aquino, Sultan Kudarat, and others, even including those we do not know their names, who vanished under the anonymity, yet had invested their lives also for the freedom that you and me are now enjoying. So we are setting aside August 22 this year to be able to celebrate, to commemorate, and to celebrate what these Filipino heroes have done to our country. In the same way that our country pauses to remember the sacrifices made for our freedom, we are to pause. We are to remember God's grace also. And the sacrifice the Lord Jesus Christ made in your behalf and in my behalf at the cross, so that we won't be failing of the grace of God, so that we won't fail of the grace of God. That is remembering. So please do understand that God's grace, this is the blank, never fails us. God's grace never fails us. But our text warns us that if we do not look at our heart's bitterness, you and me will fail to live a life that pleases God, and will fail to receive the benefits that He has made available to us through His grace. The first century Jews, by the epistle of Apostle Paul to the Hebrews, received this epistle, and they were enticed to return to the rituals of Judaism rather than standing firmly in the grace and resting in the finished work of the Lord Jesus Christ. That is why how important this epistle to the Hebrews is to them in those days. In this passage, we are to exhort, or we are to, exhorted to remember God's grace first. Remember to forgive. Okay, going back to our text, look at Hebrews 12:14. Remember to forgive. Our text says, follow peace. You see that? Follow peace. Sometimes we follow our own desires, which are influenced by our own nature. Follow peace with all men. There you are. Follow peace with holiness, without which no man shall see the Lord. What do you understand? How do you understand this verse? We are to follow peace with all men. Otherwise, we cannot understand the Lord. Otherwise, we will fail to understand Him. You will never grow in grace if you harbor what? Bitterness. We cannot grow in grace if we harbor bitterness in our hearts. Because bitterness and grace cannot exist at the same time in our heart. They cannot exist. We are not going to enjoy God's grace if we have bitterness in our hearts. No doubt, people have wronged you or have disappointed you. No doubt, some have disappointed me, have wronged me. In the same way that also I have wronged other people, and I have caused some disappointments in their hearts. In the same way also that you have wronged people also. Some were deliberate because of wrath and because of anger. Some even we are not fully aware that we have wronged or has caused somebody to stumble because of our words, our actions and our actuations and our decisions. But no matter what people have done or failed to do, you and me are commanded by the Lord to forgive. You and me cannot experience the joy of the grace of God unless we are willing to forgive. You agree with that one? So first, forgiveness pursues peace. Ang atong pagpasaylo, sundan og kalinaw. Ang atong pagpasaylo, sundan og kalinaw. In Romans chapter 14, verse number 19, let us therefore follow after the things which make for peace. Follow after the things which make for peace, and things wherewith one may edify another. You know, bitterness is prevalent in our society today. People are committing mistakes and have wronged other people, and so they're hurt and has caused so much bitterness in their heart. And because it is the tendency of human beings to cling to personal pain rather than what? To forgive. Many are holding grudges from past offenses. You agree with me in that statement? Many are holding grudges from past offenses. Only by His grace can we overcome our fleshly desire for vengeance. Kay kanang pagpanimalos, fleshly desire man na siya. Kanang pagpanimalos, mao man na siya ay kinaiya sa atong old nature. Ang ganahan kayo ang tao nga manimaos. Og ang the act of vengeance is greater than the amount of offense. Kung na-offended, tagus ka kutsara, manimalos, tagus ka kapala. Ha? You agree with that statement? Na-offended kag usa ka kutsara, pero bausa ni mo usa ka pala. Ingon ana ang atong old nature. So, only by His grace can we live at peace with God and with those around us. God's grace seeks to make peace with others. And God did not wait for us to approach Him, but it was the Lord Jesus who came to seek and to save that which was lost. Siya mo inanaog gikan sa langit ug mianhi dinhi. Aron ang mga makasala kasama kanimo ug sama kanako mapalgan ug maluwas niya. By God's grace, we must take the initiative to forgive those who have offended us, just as the Lord Jesus Christ took the initiative to forgive us. Every relationship in our life needs a forgiver because we are sinners. We are violators of God's laws. We are violators of human morals. We are violators. Go to the jail and there are so many violators of the laws of the land. Tanawa, porting daghana ditong violators. Because we are all sinners, we are violators. And every relationship in human life needs a forgiver. Needs someone who pursues peace regardless of who is at fault. Ang pagpasaylo, dili magtanaw kinsay sadaan. Kay og tanawon og kinsay nakasala, lain-lain tag-interpretation sa panghitabo, lisod kayo pagpasaylo. No? So, take the responsibility to restore, that is the blank there, the relationship instead of waiting on the other person to make the first move. We should not make the first move. If we are the ones offended, we must be the first one to make the move. We must be the one to make the first move. Notice what the Lord Jesus Christ is teaching you and me in this subject matter. In Matthew chapter 18, verse 15, the Lord Jesus Christ speaking, Matthew 18, 15, "Moreover, if thy brother shall," take note of the word "shall," "trespass against thee." "Shall" is connotes for future, but with certainty. It connotes for the future, but with certainty. When MacArthur said, "I shall return," he did return because of what he said. "I shall return." So there is certainty. The Lord Jesus Christ is certain that brothers will trespass against another brother. "Moreover, if thy brother shall trespass," so siguro na, nga ang atong igsoon mo trespass against naton. In the same way that we also have the tendency to trespass against our brother. "If thy brother shall trespass against thee, stay in your house, wait for your brother to come to you." Is that the order? No, he did not say that. The Lord Jesus Christ said, "Stay in your house, wait for him because he will come to you to make amends. He did not say that, but he said, go and tell him. You see? Ang karon, pwede na matag-cellphone. Pwede ka itong tawagon. No? Pero kaniadong wapay cellphone ng Christ, go. Og napay cellphone kaniadong, at least may ng Christ, aduwa siya or tawag ka siya. Maybe, no? But go and tell him his fault between thee and him alone. What is this? What is the meaning of this? Privacy. Between him and thee alone. Ay ang atong kinaiya, atong mga ipanabi. Kay gusto kita haitang mo air out sa garbage nga nasa atong kasing-kasing, no? Atong ipanabi, that is not biblical. Si kuan ba? Nga naman po, te kong ibuo sa gahapon. Ay, nga naman mo, kamayag yung sukmago, no? Pastilan, no? Di pa kuluwas ay. Oo, dili man na order sa Ginoo nga manabi ka. Niyo siya, go to him. Tell him his fault. Nga nung emphasize man niyo, niya. Tell him his fault. Between thee and him alone. Kaya ayaw ipanabi, ay paniguilon sa uban, kay matakdan man. Kay inig panabi ni mo, muingon man nito sa, maogi na siya. May kanik, ewan niyong sukma ka. Oh, maogi na siya daan, pag ikaw ng tawanan, maldito, ginakayog. Ako pa daing na to, ako na tong gisukmag. You see how dangerous it is? How you are spreading fire in our, as we try to relieve ourselves? Dili man na mo relief. Ang Ginoo may nagsulti. So, ma-relieve ta kung kita mo yung musulti. Now, poros magkita masalaypon, poros magkita doon na insecurities. Mo-confess lang ko ninyo. Why is it that you and me are not able to do this every time we are hurt? Do you know why? Do not I fear. Usas mga fear nga gi-entertain natin sa itong kasing-kasing, basig mo samot. Basig mo samot, Brother Edwin. No? Musamot lang gini. Nga naman, giro kayo na, taas kayo na garbo, asa na mo accept. Wa pa kakadool, imunang gi-sulay o figure out, unsay mahitabo. Hadlo ka. Nga musamot. Di na lang kumuha to kay musamot o niya. I think that is not good. It is not good. Let us overcome our insecurities and our fear in regard to this matter. Mayingon ta, pananglitag di siya mo akseptar. Musamot lang ko ka-offended, so di na lang ko muadto. Do you know why? Nga musamot lang ka-offended, kay naapo tayo itong kagalingong garbo. So, gituluan tas Ginoo nga pagduol dito haron ang atong garbo mismo, atong masalikway. Di man pwede. Ug muduol ka nya na kay garbo. I agree with that observation. Kung naa kay garbo, samot. Mag-away panoon mo kay di man mo agree. So, dili siya mo agree, nga imo i-explain og hinahinay, and then na siya isulti, maybe ikaw nakakontribute to sa maong sitwasyon. Adto ka dito makakita, makadungog ka niya nga, ako tong nahimo, Brad, kay Moni, chak, and then ka, maoba. Yeah, and it will help you better understand and become more objective of the situation. But the most important here is, masalikway na itong atong garbo if we do this, no? Thou hast, he shall hear thee, thou hast gained thy brother. But if we do not forgive, we will never enjoy and we will never receive the benefits of peace. So a gracious man works to find solutions. Okay? Mangita siya pagi. Mangita siya pagi. Lately, ga-istorya ko kung sa tao, gibundakan ko. Dili naman abundak ron. Gi-off ba? Yang atong proud, ang atong pride, ma-hurt na yung ta. Uy, gibundakan man ko sa una, bundak man to, no, anak man to, kaya maupaman na itong telepono, karoon di na, imurang pisli itong pak, awa na, offline na mo. So, ma-hurt ka because of your pride. Unya, mingunin ka, nga naman to, Lord, what am I going to learn here? Mingunin ang Ginoo, imong pride. Imong pride na, na-hurt ka, kay tungod sa imong pride. Mangita tagpaagi, mangita tag solutions to live in peace. A gracious man follows after the things things, after the things which make for peace. What are the things that make for peace? Sa akong lista, akong ginalize may unsa may mga butang ug maglista kong mga butang that will contribute to the attainment of peace, that will make peace. Humility ang number one. Humility. Kay kita, ang atong old nature, naanay pride-aan. Naanay pride-aan. Ang ako lang apo, ang iyang duwaan, wa na siya magduwa. No, iya na ganing gilabay-labay. Ang iyang maguwang kay ni duwa man. No? So, purti niyang hilak. There is envy, jealousy, and pride mixed there. Wa gid tudloy nga kung apo kay gamay pa man siya kay 4 years old pa man siya. So, Romans 4:19, let us therefore follow after the things which make for peace. What are these things? Humility. What are these things that make for peace? Allowance for mistakes. Kay og makahatag tag allowance for mistakes, kita kay masayo pampunta. Angayan lang nga may masalaypon man ta, muhatag tag allowance. Ako bitang reconciliatory move. Pag ingon niya nga sorry, nalipay ko niyong sorry sa mga nahitabo, ako sa ginan, kitang tanan masalaypon, wala exempted. Ako po, ayon. So, accepting because you make also allowance for mistake is a very good ingredient towards the attainment of peace and reconciliation. Okay? What are these things that make for peace? Allowance for humility, allowance for mistakes. Peace as a result of reconciliation. Kay tinuod yun, kung doon na kay conflict sa imuisig ka tao, di ka malinaw. Inigainom-dom ni mo, to anasad. Because the root of bitterness, you know, root, di mo na makita. Tom na silaom. Onya nourish the root with the warmth of the sunshine and water and the minerals. Kanang root mo kuha na dito. Onya mo spring up. So the root of bitterness. Na dia di makita, no? So peace as a result of reconciliation and the joy of gaining a brother. The joy of gaining a brother. Finally nagka-reconcile na gid mi, di ba? So, let us follow, therefore, after the things which make for peace, things wherewith one may edify another. Tinood. Mingon ta, why ayo akong kinabuhi, why ayo ang akong adlaw rong mga simanaw na, rong mga adlaw nga naman, napandol ko ni so-and-so. So, first, forgiveness pursues peace, then forgiveness defeats bitterness. Kinsa may makalupig, kinsa may makabuntog o mudaog, batok sa bitterness, mao ang pagpasaylo. Our text says, looking diligently. What do you mean by looking diligently? With focus, with analysis. And it requires effort. It requires full attention. Looking diligently requires deep concentration and of course the sharp focus, no? Looking diligently lest any man fail of the grace of God. Because by not looking diligently, the Bible says we are going to fail the grace of God. No, lest any man fail. So failure to look diligently causes us to fail of the grace of God. Lest any root of bitterness. Darjon, palihog kong flash sa Hebrews 12:15. Okay, 12:15. Lest any root of bitterness na igamot. Usually ang gamot di ra mamakita. Usually ang growing root dili makita. No? Tuana sila sa yuta. The root of bitterness springing up. And when it springs up, mupakita na siya ang resulta, it will trouble you. And many are defiled. Mahugawan ang atong kinabuhi. Bitterness will defile and impoverish your soul. Someone said, bitterness is a poison. It is a different kind of poison. Why? Because it destroys only the vessel that holds it. Muriatic acid, makahilo. Pero wala niya ma-destroyed ang plastic nga nag-contain ini. Daghan kayong makahilo nga substance, pero labian ng mga pangpatay o mga insects sa tanom, alang sa tanom. Pero wala ma-destroy ang container. Pero lahi ang bitterness. It is a poison that destroys only the vessel that holds it. Your bitterness against another person, you know, will not damage the person. You agree with me? It will not damage the person. Probably he is not even aware of it. But it will have a long-lasting negative effect on you and on me. He may not be even aware of it. But it will have a long-lasting negative effects on you, both physically, not only physically, but emotionally and spiritually. First, looking diligently is our text. We are to look diligently for any bitterness in our lives. Ayuhon ginatog siksik. Tanawon gyatog mayo kay dili ta buot nga ang pagka bitter ang pagka sabi binisay bitter ma'am ha kanang pait ba bitter ha pait kayo gid akong gibati pasang pait ta ang pagka bitter will never give us good health but it will cause us to suffer some health problems. So searching for bitterness in our hearts is very important. And the reason why bitterness requires such diligence is that it is a hidden problem. Ikaw ragyoy nasayo niana, unya mo manifest ra ba na siya sa imong mga actions o sa imong mga reactions. Ngano mo magutagda? Maybe basig bitter ra siya nimo. Mo manifest, no? Because our heart is so deceitful, the heart is deceitful above all things and is desperately wicked. Who can know it? Jeremiah 19:7, something like that. Because our heart is deceitful, we are often blind to our own bitterness and its devastation. Butata, dili ta makakita. Ug unsa ka devastated ang mahitabo sa atong kinabuhi sa dihang nag-entertain ta og bitterness sa atong kasing-kasing. Undetected, it secretly grows. Magtubo ra na siya sa atong kasing-kasing, no? And robbing us of the riches of God's grace. Luoy, kita ra poy luoy, kita ra poy biktima. Kitang dunay mga kapait nga gibati sa atong kasing-kasing, kita ra poy biktima ni ana. Kita ra poy luol, luoy. So what are we going to do? Ask God to reveal any bitterness in your heart and to give you the grace to forgive. Maura gina yung solusyon. Forgiveness is the only way to loosen the grasp of this formidable foe. Mura ka gituok ani nga kaway kaning bitterness. Nga unsao man pagpaluag, maluagan ang iyang paggrip ba? Tuakon ka. Unsao pagpaluag ana? Forgiveness. Ang makapaluag ni ana. Overcoming forgiveness is one problem that every Christian is struggling. Yeah, I am also struggling. Sometimes sa diha nga mag-istoryahan ay ta sa atong asawa, sa inyong mga bana, nga ma-offended mo, No? Mangluod mo pila ka oras. Mangluod mig pila ka adlaw. Ayaw po ng simana. Or ayaw po ng buwan. Grabe hasa ng panglora. Nisap mo sa mutag suffer. O niya, ang ato ang gastric juice mo mugawas tungod anang luod-luod and then maulser no nang atong labas. Ephesians 4:30 says, "And grieve not the Holy Spirit of God, whereby you are sealed unto the day of redemption." Ang gasilyo na to hangtod sa adlaw nga kita ma-rapture, dili na to pahiubson. Dili na to siya sakiton ba? Grieve not. Kay maubray gasilyo na to. Gikan karon hangtod sa adlaw nga kita pagasuluban o mahimayaon nga lawas. Verse 31, nagingon, let all bitterness. So mag-grieve ang Holy Spirit if one of the things that we are not putting away from our lives is bitterness. Mag-grieve siya. Di na to i-put away ang bitterness. No? Let all bitterness be put away from you. Let all bitterness, let all wrath and anger and clamor and evil speaking result of this bitterness. Pait kay imong gibati ng tawhana, kay nasakit kag mayo and mugawas di ang wrath, musamot di ang anger, mugawas di ang clamor, complaining, and then evil speaking. This must be put away from you with all malice. What is malice? Ill will. What is malice? Desire to harm. Bisan tuod og naa ka wheelchair, you still have the capacity to desire to harm. Kana dayo, mayra og mayra madagma. Mayra mapakong. Ha? Bisan it is not necessarily you have physical strength to do harm. But in your heart, you desire. Nga merag, mamatay. You see? Huh? Mga butang yun, anak. Okay? So, with all malice, with all bad intentions, with all damaging intentions, ipaput away na siya. And verse number 32, but instead, be kind one to another. Understanding. Tender-hearted, forgiving one another. If you are not tender-hearted, you cannot forgive. Kay kanang tender humok ba? Lata na to ang putsiro para mahumok porting lamia. No? So ang atong kinaya nindot sa gayo kon humok. Pero gahi gani, dita pa ka forgive. No? Mangita pa ka kutsilyo para mahiwa ni mo kon gahi. Even as God for Christ's sake hath forgiven you. That is Ephesians 4, 5:32. When we are to overcome bitterness, when we are able to overcome and to forgive others, musunod kalinaw. Musunod ang kalinaw. So many people who are rich in this world, unya way kalinaw, dili makatuog. Mo resort of drugs. I learned that Elvis Presley drugs ang hinungdan sa kamatayon kay di makatuog. Even I learned from the write up, even Michael Jackson wasn't katuog. Even there are theories concerning the death surrounding the death of Marilyn Monroe. Ni drugs kay wa gyapon katuog. Di katuog ngano man, walay kalinaw. Pero ang dunay kalinaw astang nindutas katuog, magluwaw pa. How can we overcome bitterness and why are we going to overcome bitterness? You know why? Because our stubborn attachment to our bitterness and our refusal to forgive others actually grieves the Spirit of God. That is why we have to overcome. We have to overcome. Ato gini dagun ba? Daugun gini na to. Kay we do not want to grieve the Spirit of God who has sealed us unto the day of redemption. And when we cannot find it in our hearts to forgive the sins of others, we are building a wall between us and that person who has, whom you think you have offended you. And the same wall that you are building is this wall that also separate us from God. Sometimes feel na to nga murag dili ta paminawon sa Ginoo. Sometimes feel na to nga bugat kayo ang prayer, murag magdi paminawon. Di ay nag-entertain da ita, nag-harbor da ita og bitterness atong kasing-kasing, no? Refusing to forgive is an abominable sin in the eyes of God. That is sin in the eyes of God. In fact, suko siya kaya na, dili gud siya mo forgive nato. And forgive us our trespasses as we forgive those who trespass against us. That is the model prayer of the Lord Jesus Christ. So we have done nothing to merit the forgiveness of God that He has extended to us through grace. Wa kita. Tungod lang kay ang sakripisyo ni Christ mo'y halad ang gidiman sa langit. Parang ikaw ug ako, mapasaylo sa itong mga sala. Ang halad sa iyang kinabuhi o ang pag-ula sa iyang dugo dito sa Cruz Calvario. Maoray ginay rason nganong kita, ikaw ug ako, napasaylo sa itong mga sala. Nganong di man punta makapasaylo? Nganong di man ta makapasaylo? Si Jesus Christ gani para nga makaprovide o forgiveness na ito, miula sa iyang dugo, dili ba ta makapasalik? Dili ba ta makasalikway sa ito ang kaugalingon nga garbo? And embrace humility to be able to forgive. So, how can we conquer the stronghold of bitterness in our hearts? We must conquer that stronghold. Ningon ang scriptures, follow God's command in the scriptures. 2 Peter 3:18, nagingon, but grow in grace. There you are. Kinahanglan nga patubuo na to ang atong spiritual nga kahimtang, pinagi sa grasya sa Ginoo. We are not going to grieve the Spirit of God. And in the knowledge of our Lord Jesus Christ, Lord and Savior Jesus Christ, patubuo na to ang atong espirituhano ng kahimtang, pinagi sa grasya sa Ginoo. Patubuo na to ang atong kaalam, ang atong kahibalo, mahitungo ni Kristo. And that would mean searching the scriptures daily. This book of the law shall not depart out of thy mouth. Niingon si Moses, applying to myself, this book of the law shall not depart out of my mouth. I'm going to meditate therein day and night so that I will know what all the commandments that are written therein. For I am sure that I will have my way prosperous and at the end I will have good success. That is claiming the verse. Claiming the verse. Joshua chapter 1 verse number 8. Grow in grace and in the knowledge of Lord Jesus Christ. How can you keep a root of bitterness from defiling your faith? Dili pwede. Labnuto na to, ibdo na to. Uproot ba? Uproot. Uproot. Dito sa kong taas, doon ako yung mga garden dito. O niya na yung tubo, o niya sa duha ka simana, wala na akong mabisita, puti ng pagkakaya, maguha kong pliers. Kaya di na ako maibot, o madamang ka din ako, sakit kaya kong kamot, magda akong pliers. Parang ma, pliers na ako, o niya akong maibot easily with my strength. But I am doing extra effort to be able to uproot it. In the same way also. It requires extra effort. Pamaagi ba? Para dili kayo bugat ang pag-ibot, pag-uproot sa bitterness. Surrender your wounded spirit to God. Huh? Surrender. Cast your burden. Cast your care upon Him for He careth for you. So atong isurrender ng atong wounded spirit and find help in His Word. No? The grace that God gives you when you surrender your brokenness and fill your heart with His Word will help you to let go of the bitterness that controls you. Remember, be reminded, Proverbs 4:23, keep thy heart with all diligence. Examina nagmayo. For out of it are the issues of life. Casting all your care upon Him, for He careth for you. Guarding your heart is a critical important affair that you and me must attend to every now and then. Importante kaya na siya. A bitter heart will not bring forth fruits of grace. Ang kasing-kasing nasakitan, ang kasing-kasing nagatiman og kapait, no? Dili gyud na siya mo yield og fruits of grace. So Jesus Christ says in Matthew 7 verse number 17, even so every good tree bringeth forth good fruit, but a corrupt tree, an unforgiving heart, a heart that harbors bitterness, bringeth forth evil fruit, evil speaking, clamor, wrath, anger. So that's bitterness. Remember to focus, and then remember to forgive, then second, remember to focus. Remember to focus. And in Hebrews 12:18, for you are not come into the mount. This is referring to Mount Sinai that might be touched and that burned with fire. Mount Sinai then was burning with fire, nor unto blackness and darkness and tempest. So, gidescribe ang Mount Sinai sa panahon sa mga Hudiyo, dito ni Moses, dito sa wilderness. But, verse number 22, but you are coming unto Mount Zion, kita, unto the city of the living God, unto the heavenly Jerusalem, to an innumerable company of angels. You see? To an innumerable company of angels. Mauna ang mahitabo nato sa dihang we will be joining among others in heaven, New Jerusalem. The Jews had grown up hearing about God's giving the law of His people to His people at Mount Sinai. And let us understand the contrast between Mount Sinai then and Mount Zion, which is the symbol of grace. And so, first, keep a heavenly focus. And we would end this one with this subtopic, keep a heavenly focus. What an awful, what a fearsome place at the foot of Mount Sinai it has been before. Makahikap laka, patay ka. Ningon ang Ginoo, Moses ay sila paduulad rin. Kaya makahikap sila, mamatay sila dayon. Mura sila makurintihan. If anyone trespass the boundary and touch it, they immediately die. It burned with fire. That was then. The blast of the trumpet and the voice of God sounded so terribly that the people wished to hear them no more. It was a staggering display of the holiness of God Almighty. But below is not our focus anymore. We are now under the age of grace. And a new heaven, a new heavenly city will be our eternal home. That should be our focus. Remember to focus. Focus on our coming heavenly home. Physically, Mount Zion is Jerusalem. But spiritually, you know what? Mount Zion is the new Jerusalem, spiritually. In Psalm 48:2, beautiful for situation, the joy of the whole earth is Mount Zion. The joy of the whole earth is Mount Zion. So, there you are in Revelation 3:12. Him that overcometh will I make a pillar in the temple of my God, and he shall go no more out, and I will write upon him the name of my God and the name of the city of my God, which is New Jerusalem, which cometh down out of heaven from my God, and I will write upon him my new name. And Revelation 21:3, and I heard a great voice of heaven saying, behold, the tabernacle of God is with men, and he will dwell with them, and they shall be his people, and God himself shall be with them and be their God. That is our future. So focus on our heavenly home. Rather than the terror and the trembling of Mount Sinai, we look forward to the new Jerusalem, where you and me will spend for all eternity our intimate fellowship with God. We will be spending for eternity our intimate fellowship with God. And this deliberate focus makes earthly trials seem less significant and helps us to trust Him and remain faithful. As we focus makita na to nga magahinay o magadili na significant ang mga kalisdanan ining kalibutana. Dili na lisod. Why? Because we focus on the heavenly home. Helps us to trust Him and remain faithful when difficulties come our way. So that is the first part of our lesson, remembering grace. Atong i-pray nga magpadayon kita next week for the second part. So the concluding part of this lesson, let us read together in the bottom paragraph together now, everybody, with your copy ready go. The greatest sacrifice of all time is the death of Jesus Christ on the cross, where He won the victory in the battle for our salvation. We must never forget the grace of God has bestowed upon us. Hebrews 12 reminds us of three specific truths. We must forgive our enemies. We must focus on Christ Jesus and His blessings to us. And we must fear God, separating ourselves from the society that refuses to reverence Him. If it does not rupture in this week, we will be meeting again this coming Sunday, May 22. I want you to read and study again Hebrews chapter 12, verse number 14 to 16. Let us pray. Heavenly Father, we thank you so much for the lesson and the things that we learned and derived from this lesson. Be glorified in our gathering this morning, in our worship service. Be with Pastor Kent as he preaches. In Jesus' name we pray. And the people said, amen and amen.
Amen. Praise the Lord.